These patients are characterized, as I said before, by younger age. So in planning the treatments, we need to try to offer to those patients the longest period free of myeloma. And another characteristic of this patient population is that they are generally more fit than older patients, so they can be treated with high-dose chemotherapy followed by autologous stem cell transplantation. So basically, all treatments for this patient population is based on autologous transplantation. And this can be done today also because new drugs have not been demonstrated any superiority against autologous transplantation in terms of prolonged disease control. So nowadays, still in the new drug era, we treat younger patients with autologous transplantation, and we are helped by new drugs because they are able to reduce the disease burden before autologous transplantation, and they offer us the possibility to give a maintenance therapy after autologous transplantation, then improving progression-free survival and overall survival.